السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد من على الأنبياء تقدم، وكان أفصح العالمين منطقا إذا تكلم، سيدنا ونبينا أبا القاسم محمد. اللهم يا ربنا زده شرفا وكرما وتعظيما وإجلالا وقدرا، وصل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله، نستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا مثيل له في علو شأنه وعظيم سلطانه، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده وحبيبه ورسوله، أرسله من أرجح العرب ميزانا وأفصحها بيانا، فأوضح الطريقة ونصح الخليقة، صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وذريته وخلفائه المهديين من بعده ووزرائه العاملين في عهده، خصوصا منهم على الأئمة خلفاء رسول الله على التحقيق أمراء المؤمنين حضرات أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي ذوي القدر الجلي، وعلى بقية الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون، اتقوا الله وأطيعوه، إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. O Muslims, brothers and sisters, الحمد لله الذي خلقنا مسلمين. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He created us Muslim. We came completely dressed with Islam. Because we say La ilaha illallah, and Allah and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man qala La ilaha illallah, أي محمد رسول الله أيضا، دخل الجنة، enter paradise. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us saying La ilaha illallah, not to freeze our tongues at our death, not to freeze our tongue in the grave, not to freeze our tongue in the day of judgment, but always to say La ilaha illallah محمد رسول الله. And Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم knows that the disturbance that come to us comes from Shaitan. Shaitan is the main source of problems. Don't think that There is no effect of shaitan on ourselves. We are in a struggle between good and evil. So evil represented by shaitan, good is represented by heaven. And perfection is for Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. You are of the best character. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have sent you mercy for the humanity. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah gave him that status. He knows that we have in our homes too many shaitans. And the biggest shaitan today is so easy in our homes. That shaitan play with us through that. Screen of television. Too many things comes from there. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam knows that in every home there is a shaitan. And in every home means in every person there is a place that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by his order allowed shaitan to go in to see his servant how he is going to react. So Prophet is warning us, be aware of shaitan. So he said in his hadith عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه وأرضاه أنه قال أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا تجعلوا بيوتكم مقابر. Don't make your homes dead. Graveyards. Don't make your homes a graveyard for yourself. When you go to a cemetery, lot of shaitans there. Jinn stays there. That's why it's not recommended to go to cemeteries at night. After Fajr, it's yes. But not at night after Isha. Too many bad shaitans there. And in your home, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, don't make your home a graveyard. Because his shaitan is there. So he wants us to throw shaitan out. So what he said? الشيطان ينفر من البيت الذي تقرأ فيه سورة البقرة. You want shaitan to be away from your home? What you need to do is to recite سورة البقرة. When you come home and you see your wife has a problem, your children, they have a problem, you had a problem, don't pour your anger on them. Immediately take a shower or make wudu, pray two rak'at, and read Surah Al-Kahf. If you cannot, Surah Al-Baqarah. If you cannot read Surah Al-Baqarah, open a CD or open whatever, a tape recorder, reciting Surah Al-Baqarah. What will happen? Shaitan run away. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is giving us a medicine, a remedy. We go to a doctor, we say, oh, my wife is this, or my husband is this. Sick. Sometimes they say schizophrenic. Or bipolar. Okay. Because shaitan is there attacking us. So what Prophet is giving us a medicine? Listen to Prophet, not listen to doctors. He said, read Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take shaitan out. The importance of Quran in our homes. Always have a Quran in your home. Even you have to read one page, read one page. In another hadith, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, still we are for the third week continuing the importance of Holy Quran, of reading the Holy Quran. You know, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to warn Sahaba from Dajjal, the Antichrist and the Messiah. He used to tell Sahaba, be aware of the anti-Messiah is coming. It is mentioned in many ahadith that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from the signs of the last days is the appearance of anti-Messiah, Masih al-Dajjal. Sahaba used to look behind the palm trees if anti-Messiah is coming in their time. Prophet didn't say a time, because Allah knows the time. Prophet mentioned that there will be anti-Messiah is coming, and Sayyidina Isa will kill him. But that anti-Messiah means also everything that is wrong in your life. Prophet wants to tell them that there is a someone who is the head of evilness is coming. Anti-Messiah is partner of Iblis. They work together. Prophet mentioned many ahadith, be careful of the anti-Messiah. So means be careful, everything evil, be careful from it. To get rid of evilness from your home, what you have to do? Or from yourself. Prophet said, أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من حفظ عشر آيات من أول سورة الكهف عصم من الدجال. Whoever memorized 10 verses of Surah Al-Kahf from the beginning of Surah Al-Kahf, 10 verses from the beginning to verse 10, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not protect him only, بل عصم من الدجال. He will be infallible against Dajjal. He means Dajjal has no power on him, on that person. That person who read the 10 ayat of Surah Al-Kahf every day. If Dajjal comes that day, physical Dajjal comes that day, he will be protected and he will be no power of Dajjal on him, or his house will be protected. وفي رواية أخرى من حفظ عشر آيات من سورة من آخر سورة الكهف, and whoever memorized 10 verses from the last 10 verses of Surah Al-Kahf, عصم من الدجال. He will be protected from every evilness in that day that he is going to encounter. So what we want better than that? Two prescriptions already that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is mentioning. Surah Al-Baqarah and 10 verses, either the beginning, the 10 verses beginning Surah Al-Kahf, or the 10 verses, the last 10 verses of Surah Al-Kahf, will protect us from Shaitan and protect us from Dajjal. O Muslims, really, if we want to go deep into our religion, no one can really thank Allah as should be. And no one can make salawat on Prophet as should be. Or no one can pray as should be. نحن مقصرون. We are not giving the right of to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his rights and the rights of Prophet and the right of Islam, the right of religion. We are busy. That's why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in the first hadith Surah Al-Baqarah, then in the second hadith he dropped it Surah Al-Kahf 10 verses, either from beginning or from end, to give us fa inna ma'al usri yusra. With difficult there is an easement out, ease. Prophet yassiru wa la tu'assiru, make everything easy, don't make everything difficult. بروفيت صلى الله عليه وسلم عن عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال بروفيت one day was so happy all his life gave his life to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to Islam, to his ummah, to give them something that sweet. إنما بعثت لأتمم مكارم الأخلاق, to give something sweet. He was so happy. All his life Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was worried, أمتي يا ربي أمتي. Always he's asking for his nation, for his ummah, أمة الإسلام, to go to paradise. He was concerned so much, not sleeping day and night, not sleeping at night until Sayyidah Aisha said, يا رسول الله, Allah forgave you, why you are still praying until your feet were swollen. He's worried for his ummah. He's asking Allah dua to forgive his ummah of whatever they are doing. So that day he was so happy. He said, this is the best day that from the beginning of earth, creation of this universe till today, I'm the best, happiest news that I heard. قال, he said, لقد أنزلت علي الليلة سورة هي أحب إلي مما طلعت عليه الشمس. Whenever sun rise or sunset and until it rise, all these years that this universe been created, this is the most surah I loved. Because why? He said, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened for him. Inna fatahna laka fathan mubina. We have made an opening for you, ya Rasulullah, ya Muhammad, that everyone going to speak about it. Don't worry about enemy, finished. Islam is strong. Till today, Islam is strong. And Prophet ﷺ was happy because he knows Islam will be till the day of judgment. One day, عن البراء رضي الله عنه قال, he said, كان رجل يقرأ سورة الكهف وإلى جانبه حصان مربوط بشطنين. There was a man reciting Surah Al-Kahf by the tree, sitting by himself, and he is reciting Surah Al-Kahf, and he's tying his horse, because it is a wild horse, very wild horse, with two ropes, very tight. He cannot run away. فتغشته سحابة فجعلت تدنو وتدنو. A cloud came over him, and approaching that cloud over him and over the area, over the horse. وجعل فرسه ينفر. And his horse began to push, to run away, but he is tied with two ropes. And he's a wild, means very strong, but he was unable to move from that situation. As the cloud was coming over, he was pushing to run away. فلما أصبح أتى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. In the morning, he came to Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he mentioned, فذكر له ذلك. He mentioned it to him. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, Prophet said, تلك السكينة تنزلت بالقرآن. سبحان الله. That سكينة, peacefulness, tranquility, was when it was coming down, because he was reading the Quran, Surah Al-Kahf, that tranquility was coming over him. The horse was afraid from that tranquility that is coming, because it was when you sometimes you wake up, you have goosebumps, and you shake. Sometimes something good or something bad. Here is something bad coming over them, make the horse and make the man shaking. Means that is the rahmatullah, tranquility of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is coming over those group of people, wherever they are, like came to the horse and came to the man. I will end up with this hadith. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من القرآن سورة 30 آية شفعت لرجل حتى غفر له. In the Quran there is a surah from 30 آية شفعت لرجل أو شفعت لرجل حتى غفر له. That surah interceded for a person who was reading it until he was forgiven. That surah means ask Ya Rabbi, forgive that person. And that surah kept asking until that person was being forgiven. What is that surah? Many of you know it. Suratul Mulk. تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. We'll continue next time the last three hadiths on the Holy Quran. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المستغفرين فيا فوزا للمستغفرين أستغفر الله. الحمد لله حمد الكاملين والصلاة